माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी, माननीय MOSINB, उपस्थित सभी मीडिया के मेरे प्रिय बंधुओं, वैसे माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी को और मुझे देखकर तो आपको लगा होगा कोई नए पैकेज की घोषणा होने वाली है। आखिर आपने हम दोनों को उसी रूप में देखा है, लेकिन आज जो माननीय प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में कैबिनेट की बैठक हुई, उसमें जो निर्णय किए गए, वो भी एक बहुत बड़े वर्ग को लाभ देने वाले हैं, प्रभावित करने वाले हैं। और तीन विषय वित्त मंत्रालय को लेकर हैं, मैं उसका थोड़ा सा आपके सामने रूपरेखा रखता हूं, उसके बाद माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी विस्तार में उसकी बात रखेंगी। डिपॉजिट इंश्योरेंस क्रेडिट गारंटी कॉरपोरेशन, इसका गठन इसलिए किया गया था कि बैंक डिपॉजिटर्स को अगर किसी समय RBI मॉरेटोरियम लगाती है तो उस समय उनका पैसा बैंकों से निकालने पर जो रोक लगती थी उससे उनको दिक्कत आती थी। आपको याद होगा, माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी ने ही पिछले वर्ष ये निर्णय लिया था कि 1 लाख से उसकी सीमा को बढ़ाकर 5 लाख रुपया कर दिया गया था, और आज की कैबिनेट में जो निर्णय लिया गया उससे अब यह तय सीमा होगी कि 90 दिन के अंदर ही जमाकर्ताओं को, बैंक डिपॉजिटर्स को अपना पैसा 5 लाख की कीमत तक का मिलेगा। दूसरा, इसको विस्तार में माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी बताएंगे। दूसरा निर्णय जो कहा गया है वो भी देश भर में लगभग 2.3 लाख के 2.30 लाख लिमिटेड लाइबिलिटी पार्टनरशिप जो फर्म्स हैं उनका भी कार्यक्षेत्र के अंतर्गत करोड़ों लोग काम करते हैं, उसमें जो लॉ अबाइडिंग कॉरपोरेट्स हैं उनको भी ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस का लाभ देने के लिए, और जो लगातार एक प्रयास सरकार ने किए उसमें कंप्लायंस बर्डन भी कम हो, उसमें जो क्रिमिनैलिटी थी उसको हटाकर पेनल्टी के रूप में किया है, ताकि जो सामान्य प्रवृत्ति के उल्लंघन है उसको कारावास की बजाय जुर्माने की व्यवस्था की है। इससे भी उसको कामकाज करने में लाभ मिलेगा और ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस को और आत्मनिर्भर भारत को भी बल मिलता है। तीसरा, एक MOU जो किया गया है, मल्टीलैटरल मेमोरेंडम ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग, ये भी इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज सेंटर जो हमारा IFSCA है, अथॉरिटी है उसका, और मल्टीलैटरल एजेंसी जो IOSCO है, इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ सिक्योरिटी कमीशंस, और IAIS जो इंटरनेशनल एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंश्योरेंस सुपरवाइजर्स है, इसके बीच में किया गया है। इसके अलावा जो जम्मू कश्मीर को लेकर एक निर्णय किया, क्योंकि आपको पता है कि जम्मू कश्मीर के UT बनने के बाद, लद्दाख के बनने के बाद, वहाँ के कर्मचारियों को जिससे पहले सुविधा पहले थी चंडीगढ़ के बेंच में केंद्र के कर्मचारियों को मिलती थी, अब ये निर्णय जो किया गया है इसमें जम्मू व श्रीनगर केंद्रीय प्रशासनिक अधिकरण CAT न्यायपीठों के लिए 2 न्यायिक सदस्य और 2 प्रशासनिक सदस्यों के प्रस्ताव को आज मंजूरी दी है। तो अनुच्छेद 370 के जाने के बाद जम्मू कश्मीर और लद्दाख के जो अधिकारी कर्मचारी हैं उनके लिए ये लाभ मिलेगा। इससे इन दो पोस्ट को तय किया गया है, जम्मू के लिए और श्रीनगर के लिए। मैं माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी से अनुरोध करता हूं कि आप सबको आज की कैबिनेट मीटिंग में लिए गए निर्णयों से अवगत करवाएं।
नमस्कार। The Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation Bill 2021 has been cleared by the Cabinet today. As you are aware, the Deposit Insurance Credit Guarantee Corporation insures all bank deposits, such as savings or fixed or current deposit or recurring deposits, all of them are insured. And it covers all commercial banks. So whether they are private or public sector banks, they are all normally covered. And even foreign bank branches are covered, that which is in India. Local area banks, regional rural banks, cooperative banks, small finance banks, all of them are payment banks, or normally all of them are insured. Now, each depositor's deposit in a bank are insured up to maximum of 5 lakh in each bank for both principal and interest. So I just want to give you the background of what it means. Now, what is the international coverage and what is Indian coverage? Just for a picture. Now, in India, with the increase of insurance amount from 1 lakh rupee to 5 lakh rupees, is going to cover 98.3% of all deposit accounts. Because of this 5 lakh increase, 98.3% of all deposit accounts will get covered. And in terms of deposit value, 50.9% deposits value will be covered. Now, if this is what we have in India now after this cabinet clearance, just compare what prevails outside globally. Deposit insurance coverage is only 80% of all deposit accounts globally. And it covers only to 20 to 30% deposit value. So what we have done today in India because of cabinet approval means that 98.3% as opposed to 80% globally, in India it's 98.3%. And as regards account value, we will be covering 50.9% value, while globally it is only 20 to 30% value. Now, accessing depositors' money has been an issue of also when will it be given, what conditionality prevails. Normally, at least proven history says 8 to 10 years it takes. Only after the complete liquidation do they get their money of insurance. But now what we are saying is, even if there is a moratorium on a bank, which means everything is frozen, depositors are not able to take their money out of their accounts, even at that time, this measure will set in. Anuragji referred to it by saying 90 days ke andar. What it actually means is first 45 days will go for the bank which is now in distress to collect all the accounts where the claims will have to be made, and then it will be given to this insurance company, which in real time will check it all up, and nearer the 90th day you will get the money, or in and around the 90th day you will get the money. At least by 90th day, 90th, 91st, 95th, whatever. Within 90 days, the process will be definitely completed. And not waiting for the eventual liquidation, or not even waiting for the eventual resolution. Suppose somebody else comes and takes the bank, and the bank is revived again also. But if that process takes, let's say, 3 years, 4 years, we are not waiting for that. This will give relief 90 days and immediately after that. The process itself is 45 plus 45 days. Let's understand that. And then this clearance now, therefore, is going to give relief for all those institutions which have already come under moratorium. It's not going retrospectively completely back. But if your bank has already been declared under moratorium, you'll also be covered by it. So in the future, this will be the practice. And now for those banks which are already declared under moratorium also, this will cover. Now, deposit insurance premium is normally paid by the banks themselves. The bank which has its deposits, its customers, they are the ones who pay the bank. It's not charged of customers. Here, every bank actually used to have 10 paisa premium given for 100 rupees of deposit. This is now being raised to 12 paisa. We are saying it should not be more than 15 paisa at any point in time per 100 rupees. So that is being made explicit. And we are also making sure that we will have an enabling provision in case banks feel that this has to go up, for them to go up, but within a certain prescribed limit, which will be determined by the government in consultation with the RBI. So this is largely what this cabinet approval means. These are the major substantive amendments that we're talking about. Minor definitional changes are also coming through here, but largely this will be the biggest relief we can offer to those small depositors, and going by the figures that we have, we'll be nearly covering 98.3% of all deposit holders. So this is what the cabinet under the Prime Minister's leadership has given approval for, and this is something which we'll certainly be taking to the Parliament even in this session. The second issue, which relates to the Corporate Affairs Ministry, is the Limited Liability Partnership Amendment Bill. Interestingly, one thing which really stood out for me was this act was passed in 2008, became effective in 2009, and from 2009, with about 81 sections in it, from 2009 till today, there was never a reason for touching or bringing in any amendment whatsoever. For the first time, for the Limited Liability Partnership Bill, an amendment is being proposed this time. And what is the necessity for us to bring in the amendment? I'll briefly touch upon the fact that there was a committee which was formed, Company Law Committee, which was formed in 2013. They had actually looked at the Companies Act only and given a lot of recommendation, but gradually they also were made to required to also look into LLPs. Limited Liability Partnerships. Now, why is this Limited Liability Partnership Amendment required now? Because we are doing a lot of change in the Companies Act, and those corporate bodies under the Companies Act are getting a lot of ease of doing business. Most of the sections which had criminality in its approach, criminality being the spirit with which some of the sections were written, are now getting decriminalized. For Companies Act. But for the LLP, a similar treatment had to be given, because now LLPs are becoming more popular among startups. Many small companies which are being formed by two or three partners are also facing situation where many of the sections relate to criminal offenses. I'll just give you a picture of what it is. As of today, you have 24 penal provisions in the Act, 21 compoundable offenses, and about 3 non-compoundable offenses, and there was no default under which is dealt under an IAM. Now, after the amendment bill which the Cabinet has cleared today, and that which will definitely go to the Parliament, the total number of penal provisions in the Act will be reduced to 22. Number of compoundable offences will be only 7. Number of non-compoundable offences will be only 3. And number of defaults to be dealt under IAMs will be only 12. And number of penal provisions which will get omitted will be, one of them will get completely omitted. And therefore, alternative framework will also be dealing with one of them. So a total of 12 offenses are to be decriminalized for LLPs. And then 3 sections are totally to be omitted, of which one is, of course, getting decriminalized also. Therefore, this set of amendments are, one, bringing for the LLPs a equal play field compared with the corporates, large corporates which come under the Companies Act. So somewhere between the large companies which are very well regulated and partnerships or small proprietorship, LLPs in between did not have the benefit of many of the things which were happening either under simplified regulation or under the ease of practice, whether it is under the proprietorship. So we're bridging this gap and making LLPs far more attractive and easy to handle, so that many of the startups today which prefer the LLP model can also feel equally given ease of business opportunities. So this has also been today cleared, and I'm very happy to say that this is after the committee, the company law committee's recommendations, but even then there was a public domain this whole document was put in the public domain, opinions were elicited from anyone who chose to give it. So that level of consultation is also over and done with. We had collected the views, and even those views have been looked into and taken into consideration. So one of the things which is new, which I would just like to flag off, is we are coming up with a new definition of small LLPs. If you can have small companies, why not small LLPs? So prevailing at the moment is 25 lakh or 40 lakhs is the kind of numbers that we talk about when we are talking about turnover size, and also LLPs with contribution less than or equal to 25 lakhs, the proprietor, the partner's contribution, and turnover less than 40 lakhs are treated as small LLPs. Now what we are saying is 25 lakh will go over to 5 crores, and 40 lakh, the turnover size, will now be treated as 50 crores. So even 5 crore contribution and 40 crores and 50 crores turnover will be treated as small LLPs, which means we are expanding the scope of what can be a small LLP, and therefore the businesses which need a larger turnover, larger contribution of the proprietors, will also get the benefit of being small in its definition. So even that newer element is being brought in into the LLP, and this is the amendment which has been cleared into the LLP Partnership Act, the Limited Liability Partnership Act, being amended for the first time, an act which was commencing in its operation, although passed in 2008, from 2009. And the last one, which is an MOU, is of very significant, very big significance, and that is, you are aware that IFSC, the International Financial Services Centers Authority, which is in Gandhinagar, GIFT City, they have now signed a multilateral memorandum of understanding with the International Organization of Securities Commissions and the International Association of Insurance Supervisors. This is one of the biggest multilateral forum, which has several regulators coming into it. It has 124 signatories. India joining this will enable all kinds of exchange of information and ease of doing business for those who are registering themselves in the GIFT City. And in GIFT City, there's single window for all regulators. Similarly, in many of these agencies, these international benchmark setting agencies, cross-border cooperation is one of the biggest aspects. So we'll be gaining from that. So that was the MOU signed. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. We will now take questions relating to the cabinet decisions. Number 10.
Ma'am, very good evening. Sapna here from CNBC TV 18. Ma'am, there was also talk about some more decisions that have been taken by the cabinet today. There was an expectation of some more amendments that were likely. Would you like to share anything on that, ma'am? And ma'am, one question.
You're through with this?
Sorry, ma'am.
Are you through with this? Are you through with those which I've spoken about today?
No, ma'am, I'm just coming to that.
Huh?
Coming to that also.
Yes, come to that. That's all that I have to talk about today.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. So, ma'am, you also mentioned that the DICGC bill will be tabled in this session of the parliament, ma'am.
Sorry?
You'll be tabling the DICGC amendment bill in this session of the parliament, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Can I ask one more if you don't mind?
Yes.
Ma'am, there's also talk about, your privatization agenda of the government, ma'am, and the fact that banking and insurance law amendments were on the table or on the cards of what?
It was mentioned in the budget, yes.
If you can share, ma'am, any status on that.
If there's anything, I'll share, definitely. But at this moment, there's nothing for me to share.
Thank you, ma'am.
Number 19.
अपोजिशन के लोग हाउस को नहीं चलने दे रहे हैं, इस पर आपका क्या कहना है?
ये कैबिनेट के निर्णयों से जुड़ी हुई प्रेस वार्ता है, लेकिन मैं इतना ही कहूंगा कि सदन चलने से पहले भी माननीय खड़गे जी ने, सोनिया जी ने प्रधानमंत्री जी को पत्र लिखे, कोविड पर चर्चा चाहती थी माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने, तो पूरी प्रेजेंटेशन सभी फ्लोर लीडर्स को बुलाकर वो भी करवाने का काम सरकार की तरफ से किया। उसमें भी कुछ राजनीतिक दल, कांग्रेस और बाकी, उसमें नहीं आए। जो देश और दुनिया के लिए सबसे बड़ी चुनौती बनी है, उस पर भी चर्चा करने के लिए अगर विपक्ष तैयार नहीं था और प्रेजेंटेशन देखने के लिए तैयार नहीं था, तो जनता से जुड़े हुए मुद्दों को कहां पर वो उठाएंगे? एक तो ये। दूसरा, अगर कुल मिलाकर कहा जाए कि जैसे केरल में भी देखा, अभी नंबर्स बढ़ने शुरू, तो कोविड की गंभीर परिस्थिति को लेकर चर्चा वहां पर भी की जा सकती थी। आखिरकार पिछली बार भी ऐसा ही हुआ, एक दो राज्यों से जहां से संख्या बढ़ी उसके कारण दिक्कत आई। तो सदन तो इसलिए कि चर्चा करें, और सरकार चर्चा के लिए तैयार है। माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने पहले दिन कहा हम विषयों पर चर्चा करने के लिए तैयार हैं। बीएसई की मीटिंग में सभी राजनीतिक दल के जो रिप्रेजेंटेटिव है पार्टियों के, वो आते हैं, वहाँ पर चर्चा होगी, सरकार हर विषय पर तैयार है। देखिए, सरकार चर्चा के लिए तैयार है। अगर विपक्ष के लोग मंत्री जी के हाथ से स्टेटमेंट लेके फाड़ देंगे, उत्तर दे रहे मंत्री के ऊपर कागज फेंकेंगे, बड़े बड़े मीडिया की गैलरी तक फैलेंगे, स्पीकर के ऊपर फेंकेंगे, तो ये परिदृश्य भारत के लोकतंत्र के लिए अच्छा नहीं है। हम तो अनुरोध ही कर सकते हैं विपक्ष की, आइए चर्चा में भाग लीजिए, देश के लोगों से जुड़ी हुई बातों को उठाइए।
मैं आमिर न्यूज नेशन से, जो आपने ये 90 दिन के भीतर जो पैसा 5 लाख देने की बात कही है, ये तमाम उन बैंक्स पे भी लागू होगा, जैसे पीएमसी बैंक की अगर हम बात करें तो बड़े लंबे समय से वो लोग पैसे के लिए परेशान हैं, उनकी कई दिवालियां ऐसे निकल गई। क्या उनको भी समय पर पैसा मिलेगा? क्या ये इस स्कीम का फायदा उनको भी मिलेगा जिस हिसाब से आपने बताया कि 90 दिन में मिलेगा?
एक्चुअली क्योंकि आप पीएमसी का नाम उठाए, मैं ये स्पष्ट करूं आपको, 2019 से लेकर के पीएमसी के लिए सरकार प्रधानमंत्री जी के गाइडेंस के साथ उसको सुलझाने के लिए हर कोशिश कर रहे हैं, आरबीआई का साथ रखते हुए। और मैं दुख से ये विषय कहना चाह रही हूं, ये भी कल जब पार्लियामेंट में आएगा, क्या विपक्ष को इस बिल में मन नहीं है? जनता को राहत देने वाले 5 लाख का और टाइम सीमा के अंदर इंश्योरेंस देने का जो विषय कैबिनेट अप्रूवल के साथ आ रही है, अगर इस तरीके से पार्लियामेंट चलता है, इससे स्पष्ट हो रही है कि आम जनता के लिए जो राहत दिलाने वाले बात हम ले आ रहे हैं, उससे विपक्ष को कोई ताल्लुक नहीं है, मगर आतंक फैलाने के लिए ही वो पूरे ताकत लगाए हुए हैं। This is a very important bill for ordinary deposit holders. क्या इसका सीरियसनेस समझ में नहीं आएगा? और 1 लाख बढ़ाने वाले भी मोदी जी के सरकार है इंश्योरेंस, या तो इट वॉज 50,000 रुपीज ओनली, और 1 लाख के बाद लगातार हम ही उसको बढ़ाने का कोशिश कर रहे हैं, उसका टाइम सीमा के अंदर देने का कोशिश कर रहे हैं, मगर ना ऑपोजिशन इन सब से मतलब नहीं रखता। इतना इतना बड़ा बैनर स्पीकर साहब के सामने, उनके चेहरा ढकने के लिए भी कोशिश हो रही है, इसके ऊपर कोई चिंता नहीं, दुख से कहना पड़ रहा है।
नंबर 29।
मैम, द फाइनेंशियल डिपॉजिटर ऑफ प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनीज चिट फंड and sometimes the deposits of different type of segments which are not approved bankers, is it covered in this insurance, one part? And second, madam, something related with income tax side development?
No, I very clearly read out which are the banks, the commercially operating banks. Even if they are rural banks, cooperative, but banks. That is what which gets covered under this insurance scheme. So that's one thing. The second question that you had was on the income tax portal. Yes, there were quite a lot of difficulties in the portal, although the ministry, together with the company which is doing this work, had done a trial before launching it in the early weeks of June. But after the problems were so standing out, we had asked Infosys to come and be along with them. Then Anuragji was part of the ministry as well, with him present, with me present. The chiefs of Infosys came, sat, and the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India were asked to participate in it and highlight every such difficulty which had to be resolved. Infosys is quite closely working with the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and the ministry, and rapidly there is, at least from what I hear from all the chartered accountants and income tax professionals, there is definitely a lot of improvement. I wished it hadn't happened this way, but we are correcting the course, and sooner the portal will be, as is planned, easy to use.
Number 80.
Ma'am, you said that 98.3% accounts are insured now. So is there any estimate what is the current number of accounts and the current value of deposits?
No, not as a part of this cabinet thing, but we'll have to get that data and give you. The insurance provision that we've made now will cover 98.3 deposit accounts. And as I said, it's 50-point-some percentage of account value. बैंक करता है प्रीमियम, कस्टमर के ऊपर वो बोझ नहीं होता है. जो अब हम भी अभी भी पहला भी वही था, अब भी वही है. बैंक ही उनके पैसा से प्रीमियम एट द रेट ऑफ फॉर एवरी 100 रुपीस 10 रुपीस जो था अभी 10 पैसा जो था अभी 12 पैसा हुआ हर एक 100 रुपया के लिए. मगर वो 10 पैसा जो था पहले 12 पैसा जो अभी हो रही है हर एक 100 रुपया का बैंक पे करता है. कस्टमर के ऊपर वो बोझ नहीं बनती.
फर्स्टली दिस इज अ वेरी पाथ ब्रेकिंग डिसीजन टू यू नो इंक्रीज इट फ्रॉम 1 लाख टू 5 लाख. बट सपोज आई फॉर मी इफ आई हैव 10 लाख्स इन माय बैंक एंड माय बैंक गोज इनटू मॉरेटोरियम आई विल ओनली गेट 5 लाख्स.
So the insurance cover is only up to 5 lakhs, which is inclusive of principal and interest. And unfortunately, even if you have more than that amount, you're still covered only for 5 lakhs.
SM Asif, in dinon se, Anurag ji, hamara sawal hai ki shuru mein cabinet briefing mein aapne kaha ki Kashmir aur Ladakh ka jo tribunal ek hai, jiska Chandigarh office hoga, uska zara detail bata de.
अनुच्छेद 370 जाने के बाद केंद्र शासित प्रदेश जब जम्मू कश्मीर और लद्दाख बने तो उनके हज़ारों कर्मचारी, उनके लिए जम्मू में कैट का एक बेंच और श्रीनगर में कैट का एक बेंच बनाया गया. उसके लिए दो न्यायिक सदस्य, दो प्रशासनिक सदस्य, इसके लिए मंजूरी दी गई है ताकि इन दोनों ही बेंचेस में, जम्मू में भी और श्रीनगर में भी, ये न्यायिक सदस्य वहाँ पर हों. दो इसलिए किए गए ताकि एक जम्मू में और एक श्रीनगर में होगा. तो इन सभी जो वहाँ के अधिकारी कर्मचारी हैं उनको यूनियन टेरिटरी के ही इन दो बेंचेस में, जम्मू में और श्रीनगर में, सुविधा मिल जाए, उनको बाहर ना आना पड़े.
थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स.